None have been able to conclusively demonstrate them. Please remember, I don't really have this ability. The question is, will this demonstration be enough to have this prominent investigator endorse me to her public?
Now, I know who you are because I've read your books. Perhaps for people at home who don't know you, perhaps you can tell us your credentials.
Well, Vince and I are part of a group of UFO researchers that's been together for about 35 years. Mm-hmm. I started in 1957 with the National Investigations Committee on Aerial Phenomena, which was called NICAP. And then in 1965, when the first abductee, claim came in, I investigated that together with other members of NICAP.
So you both have quite a high profile in this area, and you've written, how many books have you written now?
I've written 5 books.
And this is the one that I first came across you, was How to Defend Yourself Against Alien Abduction. A lot of the stories involve these bedroom visitors, these entities that come in at night.
So most of them do, yes. Yeah. Most of them involve altered states, like the dream state. Mm-hmm. The abduction scenario starts in the dream state.
Mm-hmm. If somebody said that the altered state is an altered state because people are dreaming or because they think they're awake and they're not, and they're just sort of having a very lucid or vivid dream, do you disregard that? Does that just not hold up with the evidence, or is that possible? Or
you decide for yourself, I guess.
Yeah.
There's not very much black and white, most of it is in the gray area.
Okay, well, that's good. I suppose I should talk about my own experience. After my abduction, essentially what it is that I seem to be able to tell people their medical background and their medical history, sometimes their current medical state. I tell you the impressions that I get. If I get nothing at all, I'll be honest and say so. And I will, if I do say things, I'll try and be very accurate, because I know part of this journey for me as well is seeing whether it is real or whether it's nothing to it. I'll stand up and face over there so you can... If one of you comes and touches me on the back, it might be interesting also if you don't even let me know which one of you is touching me.
Oh, okay.
Okay, just... Mm-hmm. It might make it more interesting. And if you just place your hands on the small of my back and just be patient, because sometimes it takes a little while. It's different with different people. Mm-hmm. I'll also have my eyes closed as I'm doing it, so I won't be able to see. So please don't say anything out loud, so I don't know who's coming up. Okay, I've got my eyes closed, so... okay. Okay, you're having real difficulty sleeping at the moment, and I don't know if this is Vince or Anne, but you're having real difficulty sleeping... there's something in your throat, or that has been in your throat. a tumor or something that was in your throat. My actual anatomical knowledge is not great, but a gland or something in the throat there that was, and this would have been ages ago, but something up there, and there's, I'm gonna turn around and look at you if that's all right. Yeah, okay. I think you have. I think you don't take, or you really try not to take, chemical prescripted drugs. I think maybe you use more sort of herbal or non-drug based remedies, because there's a real almost, if I'm shaking, but a real sense of purity almost. And I think that you had some minor heart problems, but again, nothing. I think you're in very good health actually. But yeah, but that was very clear. Here and the throat, and that you've been having real difficulty sleeping for some time. But the thing in the throat was years ago. I mean, literally decades ago. It's not not recent. Is that remotely?
Remotely, it's exactly.
Really? Did you have something in your throat?
I had a thyroidectomy in the 1960s for a benign tumor. I had a low thyroid.
Right.
It's about the only surgery I've ever had up there. I do have trouble sleeping.
Mm-hmm.
And the other thing you said, that I do not take pharmaceuticals. So.
Yeah, is that true?
Yes, I'm almost exclusively alternative medicine.
Okay.
I don't trust Western medicine or pharmaceuticals.
Well, you seem to be in good health, so that's...
I am. I'm in excellent health.
And wow.
I found it amazing. I mean, the accuracy was astounding. He was accurate to 100%. I've written for the Journal of Scientific Exploration. I think possibly this would be the best place for Richard, because that's a refereed scientific journal. I mean, this should go to the very highest, most respectable publications you can find. At the next board meeting of MUFON LA, I'll bring up the idea that Richard would make a most remarkable speaker.